you step foot in this yard.
Why, it's half my house.
Now, I'm gonna call the police.
For what?
Disloyalty, boy.
Disloyalty? What is you talking about?
Don't act like you don't know what it is, homeboyo. You ain't been to the set, ain't came to none of the meetings.
Hanging out with old men, ignoring your homies, acting all superior? Your mama would turn over in her grave, boy.
So you giving me a lecture about not being a good enough gangbanger?
Gangs is positive. That's all we got, my nigga. That's our heritage.
Ain't nothing positive about your crazy ass. Man, where's Tanisha at?
She got more sense than to hang out with your sorry ass. You know you always been like this, boy. I say left, you say right. I say become a doctor, you say become a patient. I say, who is that?
Hello, Missy. Wow, Franklin. You never told me that you had a sister.
I'm Denise, Franklin's housemate.
And aunt, my mother's old dried up ass
sister.
Shut
the fuck up.
Yeah, shut the fuck up! Here, darling, why don't you go get yourself something nice, okay?
Thank you. Is it $7?
I said something nice, not expensive. You want to be a greedy fucking cow, huh? No. Now get the fuck out of here, all right?
You men are all the same.
Man, what the fuck you doing here?
Here with the boy, the boys.
What?
I'm fucking new in town. I'm making friends, all right? Now let's party.
Look, I had plans on getting some rest until this clown and my aunt came and fucked that up.
My nigga, I just came over here to holler at you about the little thing.
Man, I said I'm tired, dawg.
What fucking thing? I love things. I'm the king of things.
I ain't talking to you, homie.
Hey, let's go do something about the thing, okay?
What thing?
I'm talking about the little stress thing, man.
Fucking beautiful. Perfect. It's a gangbang. Let's go. Come on.
Come on,
who is this for, man? What is this
man?
Man,
just come on.
Danny, get the car. All right, I'm going.
Where's this thing happening?
Down Grove Street.
We shooting shit up, spraying some motherfuckers. I can drive by with the best of them.
Behave yourself, man. Lamar, what's happening? What you in stress set up?
We buying weight, homie. Something that'll move us up the food chain, nigga, for real.
Nothing's real in this town, nigga. Particularly where you in stress concerned.
Man, this is an investment opportunity. You got to speculate to accumulate.
Ooh! First rule of business. Hey, since we're out here banging, either you got some dust?
Fool wanna get butt naked? Homie live up here.
Hey, look, everybody be cool, man. Lamar about to do his thing, all right?
Hey, be on point, this fool janky. Courier service. Package to collect.
You got the grip?
Present and accounted for. You like that, huh?
Sample?
Now we talking. My throat getting numb already.
So we good, nigga, right? Well, let's go.
How about a taste?
No, man, we leaving.
I want a taste of the other side of the brick.
Now, you heard what your boy said. You're leaving.
Hey, give me the back! Whoa.
What the fuck?
Did we ask for a key or a fucking ounce?
Man, that's motherfucking drywall.
Hey, we got some motherfucking buyer's remorse out here.
You can't fucking hustle a hustler.
Fuck off! Ah.
We gotta get off Grove Street!
Fuck! They brought the van! We on foot now!
Chop! Save yourself!
Chop!
Get the fuck out of here!
You know who you fucking with! You wanna step this up? You better step it up!
Always this, Lamar!
Oh, shit!
Clip! That's the fastest shoot! MC Clip!
Clip! Wait right there, dog! Hold up, hold up!
Peace, peace!
And jack they ass, homie! That's our way up out of here!
He's alright! Put your fucking hands up!
What the fuck are you doing?
Hey, they taking Clip's shit!
Let's do this!
Damn, it's stinking, this motherfucker!
Shit ain't no river, man! It's a motherfucking sewer!
Then we in the right place!
Man, this
the fuck is this?
The guy keeping you out of the gas chamber. Townley's on his way. We need to talk face to face. Warehouse off Dutch London in Banning.
Oh, we can do more than talk, my friend. Quit that shit, man.
Yeah, I know.
I take speed mostly, and look at me. Boom! Best shape of my life.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could still take you, sugar tits.
That's because you're fucking deranged, not because you're in good shape.
Hey, why don't you stick to doing fucking crunches and feeling bad about yourself, all right, pork chop?
Hey, fuck you.
You know, I'm beginning to think that's exactly what you want to do.
Yeah. Jesus. Just said the same fucking thing to my wife.
You see his face that last time I popped it? Boom!
Oh, ladies! God!
The guy's your neighbor. Caesar's Place, Rockford Hills.
I see your boss, the more I like him.
I was you, I wouldn't be so critical of who others associate with.
So is he gonna be a problem?
For sure. But there's nothing we can do about it. If something happened to him right now, I'd be right under a microscope. An electron microscope of bureaucratic shit. And that would make it very difficult to keep old secrets.
Oh, well, boo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo for you. You know who else is having trouble keeping secrets, asshole? Me. After you brought Trevor in on this.
I only brought him in after you put out your press release. Townley's taking scores again. The Los Santos reboot. If we didn't control the situation and he'd unearth this connection, then what?
Then Trevor flips out, beheads me, kills my family, or raises them as his own. I don't know which is worse. Anyway, any of that could happen at any time.
Slow down. Let's think this through. What does he know?
He knows I'm alive. He knows I got money. And now he knows I'm working with the FIB.
Does he know how long you've been working with the FIB?
How long? The fuck does that matter?
Either you were working with us before the Cash Depot job, you walked your crew into an ambush, one of them spent 10 years on the run, and the other landed in a federal penitentiary. Or... we stumbled on the Cash Depot job, Brad went down, you went down, Trevor got away. The FIB cut you a deal on your sickbed, faked your death, and you end up here.
Who's to say which of those is true?
That there's any doubt probably accounts for you being alive.
Back there, Trevor made you right away, the second he saw you.
You remember after the bust, I was in all the papers. I was on the evening news, the man who killed Michael Townley.
Yeah, I was quite a trophy. A good.
Watch
I've
it.
Seen some bad drivers, but you!
Woo-hoo-hoo.
I was quite a trophy. A good head to hang on your wall.
Back then, sure.
Hi there.
Not now.
Sweetie! We going to that swinger party this weekend?
Open your
mouth! Keeping it real.
This is bullshit. This place, Davey, they've been shooting the real cunts of suburbia here the last few weeks. No way that's your guy.
Shit.
You need anything?
You are kidding me. I'll call Steve.
Wrong house. This guy isn't our guy.
Okay. You sure you don't want to silence him just to make sure?
If we're silencing someone, we're silencing the right someone. Get me another address. Hey, you want a coffee?
Can I get you anything?
Turns out that was the wrong Azerbaijani. We need a new address from Mr. K. Choose your instrument and go to work on it.
Where do we start, eh, buddy?
Wait! What are you talking?
Free dental.
Not the flyer! Come on! Don't!
Best way to make a man talk is to stop him being able to talk.
That hurts too much!
Mr. Phillips, ask him about Tahir Javan.
What didn't you ask me? I know Tahir. I did his home theater. He lives in Chumash. They're right on the Western Highway.
Well, that wasn't so tough, was it?
Did you get that? Did you hear him? Lives in
Chumash, the Western Highway.
Chumash, you're driving. Remember, terror does not take coffee breaks.
What a dick. So how are Steve and Trevor getting along?
Seems like a productive relationship.
You know, like I said, he's got his uses.
And as you can see, we're trying to take full advantage of them.
Then what?
This thing with the agency gets put to rest and we don't need you anymore.
Right. And what about Trevor?
What about him?
I need some resolution, Davey. You let him walk. You said you'd clean the whole thing up back in North Yankton.
And you told me it'd be a clean job, no casualties. There were more eyes on that town than there needed to be.
Yeah, well, according to my eyes, Trevor's your problem, Dave, as much as he is mine.
He's not a problem at all. We're monitoring him. Has he said anything about Brad?
Fuck yeah, he has. Plenty. I keep changing the subject. You know, he thinks you might actually commute Brad's sentence when this is all over.
That's good. Fine work. We'll send another letter. It's about time anyway.
Oh, so that's you who's been sending those fucking letters to Trevor, huh?
Yeah. He thinks they're from Brad, who he thinks is locked up in high security and not, well, not 6 feet under in a grave marked Michael Townley. The trainees write him. It's a good exercise.
Yeah, the fuck. How'd that get started?
A few years ago, a letter came to the federal prison system addressed to Brad. Wasn't signed, but it gave a P.O. box in Sandy. No more car accidents! But it gave a P.O. box in Sandy Shores. I played the part of Brad, and we started a correspondence.
Yeah, thanks for telling me, Davey.
I was doing you a favor. Didn't think you'd want to know he was in the same state.
Yeah, so now what? I just sit back and hope he doesn't figure it out?
It's worked so far.
He's a time bomb, Dave, and you fucking know it.
This'll do.
All right. Find out who we're looking for.
Yeah, we need a description of the target.
Yeah, I'll take care of it. Loosen him up.
No, no, please. I tell
what?
You what
loosen
you want
him up.
No, no, please.
Sparky, Sparky!
You're going to kill me! Please! No, no! Don't do it!
Hey. Now? Huh? Now? You ready to talk?
We're live.
You see anyone down there who might be an Azerbaijani?
Fuck do I know? You might be an Azerbaijani for all I know. What's one look like?
They look Eastern.
Half this town looks Eastern, Davey. You got the fall of the Shah and the collapse of communism to thank for that.
Anyone stand out?
No, they all kind of blend in. Make a call, Dave.
We're gonna need some more info on this guy. They're having a party down there.
That ain't gonna cut it, my friend.
Shit. Let me think. I remember.
Sorry, too late. Trevor, show our contestant what he's won today.
I remember. I remember. Woo! What if you get it wrong? Torturer! My mouth! I would drown! I got blood in my mouth! I would drown! Vegas! Ow! Torturer!
Ah!
man done enough for national security? I'm taking a shot of this after him.
I'm still here.
So what have you got for us? We need Trev to shake up your memory again?
No, please. He's got beer.
He's got beer.
No.
I think you're making this up.
No, I'm not.
Huh?
No.
Yeah?
I'm telling the truth.
Bushy beard? Got any beardy types at this party? Huh? Because that's all Mr. K's given us.
No.
You know, I'm thinking maybe we ought to just take two bullets and put them in our informant and just call an airstrike on Chumash Beach.
Get out the scope.
Who am I looking for?
Steve saying beard. What do you got?
Anything specific, or is some stubble gonna cut it?
Let's start at Mountain Men, and we'll work our way down until someone fits the profile.
There's a few beards at this party. Vinewood's full of weak chins. Place is famous for it.
Damn. Beards are in fashion in Chumash. Land of beach hipsters. We need more.
It's gonna be a long day until you give us some intel on our target.
He's got beer. He smokes like a fucking chimney.
I don't know. Trev, maybe one more time? Just to be sure.
No, please, no. Huh? I told you, he smokes. That's all I know.
Where you want it?
Nowhere.
I hope you're not scared.
Mr. K. Mr. K.
I don't know anything, please.
Okay.
He chain smokes. And he's left-handed.
What's that?
He chain smokes. And he's left-handed.
Ah, okay. Any of these bearded guys at the party smoke cigarettes? Mr. K says he smokes like a pack of two a day.
Redwood cigarettes?
Thank you, Mr. K.
Steve's telling me he chain smokes Redwoods.
It ain't the cigarettes that'll kill him. It's the guys who put the warnings on the packets you should worry about.
And he's left-handed.
Oh, now I get it. You're telling me to assassinate a guy because he's got facial hair, a cigarette, and he's left-handed.
I'm telling you to assassinate a guy because he's a threat to national security. The rest's details. Michael, what the fuck is wrong with you?
What? I had my eyes on a target. Listen. Anyone in that joint's got as much chance of being a threat to national security as the next guy.
Steve, it's blown. I'm telling you to assassinate a guy because he's a threat to national security. The rest's details.
Ah, I see someone. He fits the profile. Yep, fits it all the way. I got a good feeling. Well, as good as you can get while clipping a guy who probably don't deserve it. And now I'm taking a shot.
You missed. He's on the move. We need to take him here. Hit him on the fly. Don't let him leave the building. This is a shit show, Michael. He's gone. That was our opportunity, and we royally screwed it. Steve, it's over. I'm telling you to assassinate a guy because he's a threat to national security. The rest.
Ah, I see someone. He fits the profile. Yep.
What the hell?
That was the guy. I had a feeling. It'll check out.
Well, we've got him. It's done.
Woo! That is a wrap, my friends. Excellent work, the pair of you. Now, I got a racquetball game to get to, so Trevor, if you take care of Mr. K, I think we're all set.
What the fuck do you want me to do with him?
I would say he's outlived his usefulness.
Oh, come on, please.
Shut up!
That's a sport.
Let's go, come on.
Where are you taking me to?
Fuck Let's just go, okay? I ain't gonna let those G-Man fucking scumbags tell me what to do.
What? You just tortured me.
Don't ask too many fucking questions. Let's go. Get up. Come on, up the fucking stairs.
Oh, for fuck's sakes. Come on. Let's go. All right. Now you got a flight to catch. Okay? Let's get you to the airport. Oh, safety first.
Hey, how's your mouth?
It hurts.
Can you speak?
Kinda.
Are you gonna hold it together?
I want to go home. I want to see my family.
No, 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 no. You have no home. You have no family. That shit is over.
I do. They're in the morning wood. I love them very much.
No, that's your old life. That's over now. You're off the grid. You're one of the invisible people.
Just take me home.
I'm taking you to the airport. You're gonna get on a plane. You're flying a long way from this country, and you're gonna spread your message.
I don't have a message.
You're a torture advocate.
Advocate?
The media and the government would have us believe that torture is some necessary thing. We need it to get information, to assert ourselves. Did we get any information out of you?
I would have told you everything.
Exactly. Torture's for the torturer, or the guy giving the order to the torturer. You torture for the good times. We should all admit that. It's useless as a means of getting information.
I'm feeling lightheaded.
Sometimes you torture for the torturee, but only if they're prepared to pay. Departures. No one drives me to the airport. Here we be. Run. You're free.
Oh, what? But my family's here.
Your family is probably the ones who got you fucking in here, all right? Now look, trust no one, all right? You're alone now.
Really?
Yeah, really. Now let's go. Fuck off. Come on. Close!
that submarine we talked about. You gotta help me store it for a few days. Floyd, don't go quiet on me or I'll come around and I'll... Well, we both know what I'm talking about.
Okay, all right. Bring it around to Pier 400 at the Western Docks.
On my way.
Look, I'll have a truck to bring you around the warehouse.
What's this? The Union man doing an honest day's work?
There's nothing honest about this, sir. But this is a dishonest day's work, if ever I've seen one.
Hey, we're not hurting anyone.
No, but no one except whoever owns that submarine and the mercenary folks on the freighter.
Do some research on Meriwether Security Consulting, friend. They'd be on trial for human rights offenses if the U.S. government didn't protect all its contractors from any kind of suit, military or civilian. They're immune from prosecution, and they behave like they are. Murdering, stealing, high on power, guns and anabolic steroids. Lucky bastards.
Look, I don't know about that stuff.
Oh, you're right. Don't. Meriwether are employed by the richest, greediest scum on the planet to shit on the poorest and the neediest. So we are going to enjoy shitting on them.
Oh, great. I look forward to that.
Okay. Well, that's more like it.
here.
It's just down the road. Los Santos Marine, past the shipyards.
Is that sub covered properly?
It'll be fine if we just get there.
Are you being short with me?
No, sir. I'm certainly not being short. I'm just not used to this kind of pressure.
If you turn a crew onto a score, you gotta be ready for the heat that comes with it.
I didn't turn anyone on to anything. You threatened and cajoled and tricked me.
You don't want to cut? Just walk away.
I can't walk away. You're robbing my workplace and running the show from my home.
Deborah's home. No cut for you, no cut for Deborah. Well, I'll be fucked.
You can park it there.
You're sure it'll be okay there?
Sure.
All right. If you're wrong, I'll eat your sweet meats. Now get out of here.